Recently, I posted a video on this channel about one of the best Rune servers I've ever heard, the Dutch Grim Audio MU1, fanatically made by the legends of the audio industry. Check out this video if you haven't seen it yet. There I tell you who these guys are and how crazy they are. And they are really crazy. One of them is a co-author of the AES-EBU standard. So, among other things, I said there that this Rune server was largely developed for related active speakers named LS1. And together, these devices create a complete ultimate system that doesn't need anything else. Just your money and the internet. So, we have one of the most minimalistic, but not small, ultra-high-end class systems in the world, and now we will take a closer look at its most hidden interfaces. My name is Eugene, let's jump into it. So, we have a setup consisting of MU1 digital transport and a pair of active speakers. This is a digital source without analog outputs. MU1 cannot convert digital data to analog itself, it needs an external digital to analog converter. However, in our system there are only two components, a transport and speakers, nothing else. And the most interesting thing is how these speakers are arranged. LS1 are relatively compact speakers. Formally, these are two-way with a wide but very shallow cabinet spliced with massive legs which also round the cabinet, reducing unwanted reflections. This is a rather unusual solution, because more often manufacturers try to make the front panel as narrow as possible in order to minimize reflections. But here the Dutch managed to design a cabinet with a wide front panel and a shallow depth of only 6.3 inches or 16 centimeters. Looking ahead, I'll say that there is no need to doubt this decision. Everything is accurately calculated by these crazy fanatics from a country where greens are heated in a microwave. So, in the cabinet there are two drivers. The famous SysXL, an 8-inch midwoofer with a magnesium cone, one of the best mid bass on the market, and a Sys Prestige 1-inch dome tweeter. Both of these drivers are in a closed case, no bass reflex, but this is not the most interesting, of course. And these are not exactly two-way speakers, not two-way at all. If you look at the bass, you'll see another insulated closed box of the subwoofer built around the 10-inch peerless woofer. As you can see, this driver is directed upwards, which is also quite unusual. In general, we have either two-way speakers with two subwoofers or three-way speakers here, count as you like. However, this isn't the most interesting and surprising thing about LS1. Dutch audiophile fiction looks deeper and goes further. As I said at the very beginning, these are active speakers, that is, amplifiers are installed inside. The obvious advantage of active speakers is that they usually have band-by-band amplification. So, each driver has its own amplifier, which works exclusively for it, and sends exactly the portion of the frequency band that it needs. A feature, and in a sense a disadvantage of all active systems, many audiophiles rightly consider the use of simplified built-in amplifiers. However, I must say right away that all this definitely doesn't apply to these speakers. Specifically, here are the Hypix Encore top-line amplifiers heavily modified at Grim Audio, with a power of 120 watts per tweeter and midwoofer, they are located inside of one of the legs, and a 400 watt Hypix Encore is on the subwoofer. Today, a large number of modern high-end amplifiers from many well-known manufacturers are built on such amplifying modules. But let's get back to the design of active speakers, in which the use of separate frequency amplification eliminates the weakest point of any speaker, a passive crossover, in which most of the losses and quality degradation occur. In this system, the separation between the bands occurs with the help of an active crossover and a smart DSP system operating in the digital domain even before digital-to-analog conversion. And here comes the most interesting. Each of these speakers has three DACs, separately for each band. The tweeter has its own DAC, the midwoofer has its own, and the subwoofer also has its own separate DAC. So we have 6 drivers, 6 amplifiers and 6 DACs here. What a thing! Grimm's proprietary clock is also installed here. Those who watched the first video about the transport remember that Grimm Audio are the kings of studio clocks. They really make some of the best studio clocks in the world. And here they are installed inside each of the speakers. The left and right channels communicate with each other using their own wired digital protocol and are connected by a standard Ethernet cable, which are equipped with XLR connectors, which have a standard Ethernet connector inside, so you won't have problems with accidental breakage of delicate plastic connectors, which are on patch cords. Another interesting point. Grimm Audio is primarily a studio company. They produce equipment for recording professionals, and here in the design there are echoes of this studio-ness. The inputs here are only balanced XLRs, one analog and one digital. There are also special Ethernet connectors. They directly supply all audio data and control signals from the MU1 network player using some of their own closed protocol, and an XLR output to the subwoofer. By the way, with regard to the analog input, the incoming signal from it is first digitized to get to the DSP processor, where it's digitally divided into frequency bands, and then goes to the DACs and from there converted back to analog, to the amplifiers and then to drivers. Yes, the circuit is complex, but it makes it possible to connect even a reel-to-reel tape recorder or a turntable to the speakers at any time. The speakers also have their own wired remote control with 2 additional digital inputs, with which you can adjust the volume and select the active input. Plus, there is a special external audio interface with USB, through which you can connect the speakers to a computer, where you can change the settings through a special application. As for specs, here we'll see a frequency range from 20 to 27,000 Hz, a phase deviation of no more than 10 degrees, and a signal-to-noise ratio of 114 dB. The digital part is capable of processing PCM stream up to 24-bit 384 kHz and DSD up to DSD 128. What else can you dream of? Well, maybe only about the most referenced version of the speakers. By the way, it is called LS1BE and involves the use of the Ultimate Cis Beryllium tweeter and a truly advanced low-frequency part with electromechanical feedback that minimizes distortion and gives crazy accuracy of the lower frequency range. So here we have a pair of Dutch cyber speakers with 6 DACs and 6 amplifiers and their own precision room transport. Altogether, it costs like a good car, but unlike the latter, Grimm doesn't make harmful emissions into the environment. At least for you. Your neighbors may not be as optimistic. Anyway, you'll get only positive vibes. What are they like? I mean, how good does it sound? Still, these 2 components cost as much as a real big system, a pretty cool one. And here you are offered only a pair of speakers and a player. And what, the sound will be like that of a large system, or not? The answer is yes, of course it will. This setup really gives a lot of sound. By their nature, LS1s are completely unbiased monitors. They give a smooth, very clean, clear and transparent sound. They do not color or embellish the sound. LS1 serves everything as it is. The system tries to be as natural as possible on any music. Here, for example, is the latest album by electronic musician Matt Cutler, known as Loam. He skillfully mixes IDM, jungle and broken beats with ambient and some dance motifs. In general, he has a rather diverse palette. Moreover, it is well recorded, everything is very high quality and effectively done in an audiophile way. The LS1 plays this music out in front of you on a large stage, and it's all very impressive thanks to ultra-precise space localization. Everything is very elastic, fast, dynamic. Each sound seems to be laser cut in space. Not the slightest hint of any laziness or defocusing in any part of the audible spectrum. You can immediately hear that each element of the system is precisely adjusted. Everything works in absolute coherence and harmony. And by the way, since there are no bass reflex ports, these things are very tolerant of the proximity of walls. I deliberately pushed them close to the wall, and this almost didn't worsen the sound. And literally because of my suspiciousness, I moved them to the usual distance, worrying that the signal going from the subwoofer would negatively interact with the wall. Speaking of live instruments, here is an interesting album by Vincent Pirenne, a French jazz accordionist and composer. Extremely interesting and very lively, energetic, full of unusual techniques album. For example, the very first thing surprises with the proximity of the accordion to hard rock guitars. And there, on everything, something interesting happens. I won't spoil it, listen for yourself, it's just superb. Even though I don't like an accordion since school lessons of music. This system shows you each instrument very clearly, breaking everything down into atoms in a good way, so that you can absolutely understand what each of them is. And in this well-drawn multi-texture picture, confusion never occurs. The boundaries of the stage are clear, the position of each musician, how intensively he participates in the process and all that. In general, transparency, volume and details are at their maximum. These are one of the most consistent sounding speakers in my memory. And what's the most impressive is that you don't have to suffer to get it. Just bring them home, connect the cables, and that's all. They already perform great. And another novelty came out the other day. His rockiness Jack White releases an album in which he has fun with hard rock of the 70s. From the first seconds you get an impressive menacing guitar impact that rocks you over, shaking your head to the beat at the listening point for 39 minutes and 54 seconds. Divine, very impressive album. Jack is still alive. And these speakers will do everything to make you listen to him intently. They are sensitive to trifles and with great pleasure reveal to you the smallest details of White's vintage setup with all its distortions, vintage microphones and other Third Man Records gadgets. It's a thrill. So, it's a great, confident sounding system, but not without a few quirks. I'm afraid to call it a disadvantage. Well, it really gives a very cool sound on any music. But the strict and almost monitor presentation, of course, impresses with its purity and transparency, but it also has a downside. Speakers don't like low-quality recordings, unashamedly dumping recording or compression flaws on you. Listening to badly recorded music on them, well, it's not that painful, they don't even drill your ears very much, but listening to this isn't interesting, not so exciting. The speakers don't mask or embellish anything for the sake of a beautiful picture, so if you decide to listen to a low-quality vinyl rip found on the net, you won't have pain, but you may vomit. So when buying this, don't connect devices with an AirPlay here, and don't let your wife into this. With this system, the best option would be to get a divorce and permanently close in an acoustically treated room. You will most likely spend the best years of your life in thoughtful listening. These speakers will impress you with a wide, deep stage and won't shame you for spending $500 on high-res files. But speaking seriously, then of course it's not reasonable to get divorced. Who will wipe the dust from them for you? Okay, let's recap. The LS1 are very sophisticated, incredibly well-coordinated all-in-one speakers, and at the same time looking like a piece of furniture. They are very honest and neutral in sound, absolutely not limiting you in any musical experiments and discoveries. Yes, they are probably not suitable for those who are looking for some kind of special sound signature. But otherwise, especially in combination with its own transport, I think that you won't find such a minimalistic system with the same impressive ultimate sound quality.